watching to help volunteer. Because we get tired.
All the biggest guys with muscles like you have, right? They come over here and they start grinding and cutting.
Did you not bring the other grinder along?
Yes.
It should be there, yeah.
It's right in the... finding it hard.
What are you looking for? Right here. Oh, I thought you were just taking a picture.
No, no.
Okay.
Here, I should show this.
This is where we have our typical hams. And they would, years ago, this is exactly what they would do, is they would just cut, hang it like this, and this portion here would just get hung in your smokehouse or your chimney, basically, for the whole winter, because it would get heavily salted. And I know all this stuff because my parents did this stuff here. We did it when we were younger. And that was that, so that the meat would stay fresh. It wouldn't spoil right away. And I come from Paraguay. And that's where I didn't grow up there so much, but that's where I was born and everything. And I never heard of a refrigerator or a freezer until we came to Canada. So, and find ways of preserving the meat. And a lot of your other stuff, like your ribs that we cut out of here, you can use it for barbecuing out here, but you know, we didn't do that there. It was mostly they put it in kind of a stainless steel tub of some kind, and then that lard that gets cooked out of there, that lard was put over top of this meat. After you cook your meat, it was put in these containers, and the lard was poured over it, and that lard sealed it. And then it would stay fresh for pretty well almost a year. And you would just take out what you needed, you would heat that piece up then, and let the lard all melt off of that. And that lard would then be poured back into the container again to reseal it. And that was so the oxygen and no bugs could get at it. And the meat stayed good. So we didn't have pork chops that we had over here. Did you buy pork chops? There was no pork chops. But for today, for us, we're going to just cut up at the chunks. We're going to cut the ribs out of here. We will cook the ribs in the cauldron there for what we call a rapspia, or I don't know how you say it in English. Short ribs, maybe. Well, spares is something different, though. We'll grind up the lard as well, and that's your cracklings, which is really good for breakfast. Tastes delicious. So we're just going to keep on doing our stuff here.
You want any meat?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Mark, want to get one of those meat rings? Good morning.
Morning. We were late last year. You guys were stuffing already when we got here.
Oh my.
We talked to you last year. You said, you got to be here at 10. And boy, we're lined up at the door at 10 and you're going already.
Yeah. Well, tell us 10 o'clock we're supposed to get started. So that's...
They are...
I think that was... me.
I don't know. I think...
Called Schwarter.
Mm-hmm.
direct translation, that would be Schwat is black.
Black is short, yeah.
So why would we call the skin Schwat when they're not, when it's not black?
I don't know.
But we can sell this to the Blue Bombers and they can make a new football from this.
Yeah.
I think that would make a difference in their performance.
Yeah, maybe it would.
Oh, I want to go to the other side.
Okay, look at the meat.
I hear him.
Okay.
How big do you think the pig brain is? Who wants to guess how big the pig brain is? You think?
Well, you've got a mosquito by your mouth. Mom,
yeah. They're not very smart.
And on the forehead.
Yeah, there's lots out here, isn't there?
Now, this is the skin from the pig, and we've got a few little bristles on here.
Want to feel it?
Yeah. You
want to
touch it?
You can feel it.
I feel like the pig. Pig skin.
You know,
he really wants to see the real pigs.
Okay, they went to the butcher. There
are no pigs here at all.
No, I picked up. These are the pigs that were raised on this place exactly.
On here.
Yeah, I picked these pigs up last Monday.
Yeah.
And they were brought to Blumenauer, where they were killed and so today we're just
cutting them up.
Yep. But they were raised right here at MHV.
Where
they
Okay.
what are you actually doing with the meat that you're cutting out up here? Like, where does that part go? Like, what do you do with it? That's for the bacon?
That's the bacon.
Well, that's from this part right up here. Right
still.
Here.
Yeah, right in here.
Oh, this part in here.
That's the pork belly.
Oh, fat and meat. Fat and meat.
On the back end of the pig?
Yes.
From the stomach fat. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, that's
see,
right.
There's your layer is of meat and fat and meat and fat. Yeah. That's your bacon. I'm just going to take a little bit of the skin out of the bacon.
You recognize?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's from the front of the pig.
Did you get that?
The nipples?
Okay, so this is the middle part.
What have you got? A bacon! This is the bacon. You've got layers of fat, meat. Okay. We will cut the bacon
diagonal
this way, and it's your bacon. And so it comes from the belly of the pig. So these are actually the
it's
a her bacon.
Are you doing the head cheese from the pig head? You put the whole head in, and we boil the whole head. And once you're done, I think it's all
off.
And then you take it from the screwdriver, and you bust it 7 plates that come off. And Ron is always around in the brain.
Mark, come here.
I think
these guys need to see this.
Well, Engel will.
We're
going to
have mosquitoes
in our feet today.
Yeah.
Extra protein.
Yeah.
We have another half of cake to do this afternoon. We're going to have lunch.
Careful measuring system.
This is how they did it.
That's how my dad used to do.
Do it slowly. Do it more. That's good.
Dad, Uncle Corny. Okay, there. There we go.
Just a little bit of that. This can be very salty.
It will be pretty warm
again
later on.
Yeah, that's good. Wants to taste.
I will.
In the olden days, somebody tasted it to make sure it had enough salt.
Yeah, no
takers? Mark? Well, I guess it'll be good enough then.
How much do you want? You taste it.
I'm not from the olden days.
She's
a fairly modern girl. I am. I'm a city girl, remember? I didn't even grow up doing this.
I have a fish for they're married to an old fashioned man, huh?
Mm-hmm. He did taste it before, but
yeah, he did the other batch.
Yes. Hey, Mark, you want to take this out so we can fill her up? We have to clean this up.
Yeah, it is.
It could have been your job to clean them. You should have come a little sooner. Actually, we didn't clean these. Somebody else. But in the olden days, that's what they did. But they didn't make very much sausage, so they didn't have
to come. Well, they could only make as many as fantastic.
Well, and I think they kept everything, like they kept the hens, like in Canada anyway, they hung them in their chimney.
Okay.
They kept them there all winter.
See, Mama, they did ribs like that was totally like in strips instead of bacon, and with the skin on it, if they toss bacon, and they get and the chunks of on the like, big lean meat from the legs, they would cut up the strips and they would smoke them like that because they didn't have a fridge.
Oh yeah, and that's why they didn't make much sausage. You know, the hams they couldn't hang in the chimney.
Lots of horsepower.
Yep.
Not going to look at that.
Yep.